But I'd wanted to come to America. This was my big dream, ladies and gentlemen. The first time I landed in New York City, I was 18 years old. As the sun rose over the Manhattan skyline, I wept. And it had nothing to do with America or the American dream. I had breakfast. Because I grew up in a world of cornflakes, guys. Imagine a universe of endless cornflakes. And not even real cornflakes, that dirty Mohan Makin's bullshit ostrich feces cornflakes. And then I landed in New York City and somebody gave me Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Right? It fucked with my head. Because my brain knew that what I was eating was not cinnamon or toast or crunch. But my heart believed, ladies and gentlemen. Because what was cereal originally? It was just a way to get milk into kids, right? Make milk interesting for kids. What God did with tits, America did with breakfast cereal. The best version of that transaction. You don't appreciate your American luxury. I went to your supermarket the other day. You have an aisle for cereal. An aisle for cereal. There are countries with apartheid still. You have an aisle. It is 60 feet by 10 feet. That's 600. In Bombay, that's a school, okay? In Africa, that's a university, ladies and gentlemen. And your food looks so good, man. I saw an ad for French fries on TV the other day. Fuck, it should have won an Oscar. I don't know why it didn't. Maybe a black guy made it. I'm not sure, but... Thank you, racist. You know, it was cinematic. There was a golden sunset and a philharmonic orchestra and the fries fell down in slow motion with like CGI sprinkles of salt. And then there was a chick in a bikini and the fries rappelled down the side of the titty really slowly. And you're just watching that going, oh, carbs, carbs, carbs. Potato. 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 I shouldn't have done that shit. I just fucked myself. I'm gonna do legitimately intelligent material tonight. Your only takeaway is gonna be potato. How's the Veerda show? Potato. But it was an erotic experience. Chicken, bikini, there was sex with food. You can't do that shit with Indian food. Just get a naked chicken, drop hot dal all over her. Ah! But let's talk about this. Indian food, clap your hands if you agree, tastiest food on the planet. Not the best looking cuisine on the planet. Indian cuisine all looks like you digested some other cuisine. Saag paneer for dinner looks like you had Greek salad for lunch. Yeah, close your eyes, really picture it. Indian food is not visual food, ladies and gentlemen. Like, I watch MasterChef Australia. That is visual food, right? Oh, I love what you've done with the plating and the arrangement. It's amazing. You show those three dudes a bowl of bengan ka bharta, they will lose their mind. Oh, fuck. Was it in pain before he died? Can we make people look at this as a punishment for petty crimes? Like, Indian food is not visual food. It is audible food, ladies and gentlemen. Like, if you walked past an Indian restaurant and there was beautiful pictures of food, you would not go into that restaurant, would you, ladies and gentlemen? You wouldn't. But if the door opened and you heard somebody say, oh, panchot, bahut kha liya, gaan lag gayi, you would order everything on the menu. Also, Indian food is romantic food. You know, there's nothing romantic about sitting with somebody and having dinner. But if you can spend your life with somebody who's just... That is true love, ladies and gentlemen. You know, this is why I believe you could never have an Indian Bond villain. Because Bond villains are always eating or drinking something while they say some genuinely badass shit. Greetings, Mr. Bond. You should not have come here today. Tonight, you die. Bonsoir, Monsieur Bond. We have been expecting you. Tonight, you die. Indian food? Yeah, hello, Bond. See, you should fuck it. Eat this vindaloo. You'll die. Plus, Bond knows how to fire a gun. Indians are not good with guns. That's why I respect your country. You take entire control of the gun manufacturing process. You manufacture the gun, the bullet, the victim, all in-house. It's kind of good.